Welcome everybody, you're watching Mr. Fugu Data Science. Today we're using Python and Postgres to create a user-defined function called a trigger. As always, the code is linked in the description below. We need to create a new table to store the information after we execute our trigger. We are creating a function, little interface between our new table and our table of interest. And then we need to create the actual trigger and execute it. If you need to install psycopg, I suggest you do that now and pause the video. Now, import psycopg to and your user credentials, like I did here from my config file. If you do not have a config file set up, look above at the link and feel free to get started with that. Otherwise, go on the psycopg page or pause this video and feel free to do a setup such as this for your connection. Alright? Now, what we need to do is say, well, what is a trigger? This is something that came up in a job interview a while back for me. And if you see the little emoji, that's how I felt. Consider this. What you're doing is creating a function that is allowing you to work off of an event. And an event is something such as insert, update, delete, or truncate. And you could do this before, after, or instead of this event occurring. For instance, I could say I'm creating a trigger that works before insert, after update, after insert, etc. You have two types where one is working row by row as you're processing your data. The other just does it with all rows at once, called a statement. Now, here's the general layout right here, if you're curious. We need to create our connection where I'm calling my config file, which stores my parameters, which are key value pairs, where I'm calling psycopg2.connect and calling in my parameters. After I make the connection, I create what's a cursor, allowing me to send or retrieve data as well as query. I just chose auto commit equals true because I want everything to happen instantaneously after I do all my operations. Now, I'm creating a table where I'm storing all of my information after I execute the trigger. Okay? So what I'm saying is this, drop this table if it already exists and call it CPU sales update. And I'm creating an unlogged table where I'm creating a column called changed on, which is a timestamp. And I want this because I have sales data. This, it's fake CPU sales that I created, which are credit card, email, first, last name, phone number, and then what CPU and purchase date you have for it. Okay, if you're interested in looking at future sales, if anybody updated a purchase, if they updated a credit card or personal information, that's where these kind of tables and triggers come along because they could work automatically. So I just pasted in all of the parameters from the old table that I was working with, I just showed you, and the new column that I'm taking, okay? And I'm calling it by this. Now, to actually send this table off to Postgres, we need to do a with, and I'm calling the connection cursor, aliasing that as cursor, and then I call the function and its argument here, and sending that off. We could just look and see if that table is there. And now it's there, because it was just created. Then I'm creating a what I'm calling log updated sales. This is the function that the trigger is working from. All the information from the trigger is coming from here, okay? So this is going to be a little lengthy, so that's create or replace the function called log sales data. That's what I'm calling the function we're going to use. And then it returns a trigger as, and this is the table that I was using to store everything. And then let's begin our function. All of this right here are basically your notes, and you can read what's going on here while I code this out for you, where I say if I'm calling a stored, I don't know if it's a procedure, but it's basically your trigger operation, and it's working and saying, if I'm calling a delete, then I do something. So I'm going to insert into the table of CPU sales update, select, I'm calling now, which is my timestamp of what's happening now, and anything else will stay the same. That's what old dot star is. Any of the other columns after this timestamp will all stay the same. So then what happens here? Well, you need to return old. Then I need to do an else if, and I'm doing the same type of setup where I'm calling tgop, and then here I'm doing an update. And what happens? Well, if you update, then we're going to insert into our table now, which is our timestamp, and new, so everything will be changed to new. Okay, that sounds perfect. And then we're doing the same thing for the insert as well. So let's just change this to insert. And then from there, we need to end if, and then we're going to, we can say, you don't need to do this because it's actually outside of the trigger for the result. And then close out everything by end. Also, not forget by calling the CPU sales update. It's one thing I need here, but I forgot. There we are. Select, because I forgot it here too. There we are. Now, we got this sent over. What do we do with this trigger? Okay, this trigger isn't very bad. We need to, let's do a create, and then take our CPU sales update. And this is the trigger name I'm creating. So I'll just call it CPU sales update trigger. Now, we're going to say, we're going to do this after the fact. So after we insert or update or delete, and then we're saying on what? Our original table, which is our people CPU purchases, and then we're going to do this by row. So for each row execute, and then we got to call procedure, and then we're going to call our log sales data function that stored everything from above. There we are. That'll fix that. Now, what are we going to do? We need to actually check and say, let's find all the triggers in our current database. Okay, so how do you do that? You do a select, and you take everything from, and then you're going to call this procedure that's inside of Postgres. So PG underscore trigger. And now you find the trigger that we just created, and it's the only one in the current database we're using. But what about the current table we're using? How do you find anything? Well, you say the select and then TG name from, and then what you're calling the TG underscore trigger, and then you're going to take the PG class where the TG, basically the trigger ID PG class dot, and then basically the ID value and the name, the rel name, equals the PPL, which would be my people CPU purchases, and then that should, let's see something. Something I forgot. Oh, PG. There we are. So that's the trigger that we have for this current database that I set up. Then you can look and see if this database has any triggers, and it doesn't. Now, let's make sure everything works. So if we're dropping something, we could have done that. Now, I want to insert into this, since I have an insert, a delete, or an update, where I'm just inserting into my original CPU purchases, which is the table right here that I showed you. And I am putting all of the columns where I make up just some random information with my name right here. We send that off. Then we make sure that we check the new table that we created. And now we have that data that I just created, and it's the only one in our updating table with our new timestamp. Then I can say, well, let's update the name from what it was here and make sure that the update works. Now we have an update and an insert, okay? And that'll be the end of this video. So I would like to say thank you for watching. Please subscribe and throw a like. And don't forget to turn on that notification bell. And if you didn't like the video, leave me a comment and tell me why, so I can improve this channel for all of us. See you in the next video. Thank you for watching. Bye.